All right, my apologies to clarify. It was the Iceland's foreign minister, all right? I skipped over a line in my research just to clarify to our audience. Moving on to another topic. Was it appropriate for you to actually, I mean, you close a press conference. It's a classic, as some reporters told me, and you just had to say that line against Senator Leila de Lima. Happy anniversary in jail. Did you say, may you spend the rest of your life in jail? Yeah.
Yeah, I did.
Okay, the notes are here right now, so I'm going through it. Why did you have to go that way?
Because the question was, what do you have to say to Leila de Lima saying you have sacrifice your integrity and reputation for political gains. No.
But Secretary, you know she's not the only one who says that. I've known many people who also say, what happened to Harry? There are, you know that.
Yes.
You have professors.
So my feedback is, I will say it again.
What happened to him?
Leila de Lima, enjoy the rest of your life in jail. Why? Because I've heard testimony, not just from convicted felons, but from no less than your own lover, from your appointee whom you appointed as head of the Bureau of Correction, and from a deputy director of NBI that you appointed, that you are really engaged in large-scale drug trafficking. You deserve to spend the rest of your life in jail.
Yeah, but how can Senator Leila de Lima expect a fair trial when you have no less than the secretary, I mean the presidential spokesperson, saying something that blatant of you deserve to spend your life in jail?
She's got lawyers. She's got Florin Hilbay. She's got Chel Jokno, the greatest lawyers, former Solicitor General. I'm sure she will have no problems proving her innocence if she is. But as I said, when I was a congressman, under oath, I heard her own appointees, her own lover testify that she's really engaged in large-scale drug trafficking.
Of course, to clarify, this was when you were still in Congress.
In Congress.
And you did, you were questioning the witnesses during a congressional investigation. So.
And my advice to Leila de Lima, if you don't want to hear anything from me, stop saying things about me. Because remember, I'm free and can reply. You're in jail. I only respond.
But she can reply.
I only respond when she says something about me. She can't take it away from me if I respond to anything that she says. I leave her alone as a matter of principle, a policy, because she's in jail. But stop attacking me and, you know, stop expecting that I will not hit back when you do attack me.
Okay, but Secretary Harry, isn't this government, I mean, I wanted to ask you, giving a perception that it's frankly acting way too personal?
That's not personal. This is about drugs. Come on. This is about trafficking in drugs.
But your response to Senator de Lima, I mean,
well, what do you expect? She's being prosecuted by the state. I'm part of the state. She's being prosecuted in the name of the people of the Philippines.
Okay. So her statement that you sacrificed your ideals for political gain, the question now on everyone's mind, have you and will you?
Well, I do not know what political gain I've gotten, because so far I've only gotten flack. So where's the gain, please? I want to see the gain.
Okay, first, 2019, will you be running for the Senate? I've spoken to many sources, and they did tell me that you are part of the senatorial slate under the president's.
I've officially thanked the speaker, but I've officially also said that right now my concern is to do the best that I could in my current position as spokesperson.
Okay. What will make you run and what won't make you run? I mean, I'm being
the
honest.
The truth?
Yeah.
Oh, if I have the money. Okay. They say it costs at least 300 million. Mm-hmm. I do not know where to source that 300 million, even if I wanted to run. No? So I'm just being very practical.
But that's one.
The practical part of it is normal people like us. Mm-hmm. We can only dream, really, of these things because we can't afford 300 million.
Okay.